Hello everyone and welcome to my Quest World 2 spotlight. This is Quest World 2. There was a Quest World 1 version a long time ago, I think it was over a year ago. Well, and it's Quest World 2 now. It's entirely recoded and I'm here to show you some of the cool neat features I added in for you and how it works, how to use it. And I think it's pretty user-friendly, I don't know. But that's just my personal opinion. I've been working on this for over a year now, and I hope you appreciate it as much as I do, because I am pretty proud of the result. Anyway, so let's just get back into it. So the first thing you're gonna do, or you're gonna get, is upon your first join, when this plugin is installed, you will get this quest book. You can see it's the basic guide for your quests, and you can just retrieve it by placing a workbench into your crafting grid. So, in case you lose it, you can just retrieve it. Anyway, so if you open it, you will see there's not much in it except for a party menu. I'm going to go into this later, because first I'm going to show you the quests and then the party menu. Anyway. We don't have any quests yet, because we haven't created any. So, as an admin, you can do slash quest editor. And it's going to prompt up this pop-up saying you can either do quest editor GUI for the in-game quest editor, or you can import or export your quests. So, in case you have created a ton of quests and want to share it with the world, you can do so. You can just type in quest editor export derp or anything, and it's going to create a derp.zip file for you in your presets folder, in the quest world folder, in the plugin folder, and you can go ahead and share it with your friends, and they just put it in their presets folder, and then type slash quest editor import derp. That's it. You can share your quests. Isn't that cool? Anyway, I'm going to open up the quest editor GUI. And you will see we have 45 slots saying new category, because we can have up to 45 categories. So we're just going to create one, and it will tell you to type in the name of your new category. And color codes are supported, so you can go ahead and type in NA test and for category. And we have a test category. So you can left click to edit it. If you want, you can change the item, because if you're holding a compass, for example, and open up this interface, you can change it to be a compass. It's easy, just one click and having it in your hand. Then you can also change the name. It will again ask you to type in the name, and it's going to change it then. And there's also a quest requirement button. I'm not going to go into this yet, because this is some advanced stuff. So let's just create our first quest here, because at the moment we just have a category, nothing else. So we're going to open up the editor, and this time we're going to shift left click to open up a category, and it will show you 45 new quests you could create. So you can have up to 45 times 45 quests. And again, you will be asked to type in the name. This time it's going to be test quest. All test quests. Okay, man. And if you are holding an item in your hand, you can again change not only the item, but also the name. I'm going to go into this later. Well, not later yet. You can also change the rewards to be the items in your hotbar. So if I click this, you can see upon completing this quest, the user will get a quest book and a compass, because that's what I had in my hotbar when clicking this. You can also specify a cooldown, and this does work over restarts. It's safely stored for you, and you can change the hours and minutes to be whatever you want. So if a user completes a quest, it gets unlocked again after a certain period of time. Then there's also a monetary reward. If you have Vault installed, this gold bar will pop up here. And upon completing a quest, the user can get a certain amount of money to their balance. The same for XP rewards. You can give them XP levels upon creating a completing a quest. And then there's also a quest requirement button, which I'm going to explain later. So, but first, this quest is done or finished by default, because there's nothing the user has to do in order to complete it. So we're going to create a new task. Currently it's submit one stone, but we're going to change it by left-clicking on it. And you can change the item, for example, you can change the type to be either detect, craft, submit, kill, or kill named mob. Craft will mean you have to craft the item you specify. Submit, you have to give it to the questbook so it gets consumed. Kill means you have to kill a mob. And detect means you have to have it in your inventory. Kill named mob is obviously the same as kill. However, it respects entity names. So you can specify a name like level 1 zombie, and it's only going to complete the quest if a name of a zombie you just killed was level 1 zombie. This also works for player names, so if you specify the entity type to be player, you can, for example, specify Mr. Cookie Slime, and it's only going to work if you kill me. The player Mr. Cookie Slime has to be on then. So I'm just going to show you submit. We have to have the quest book in your hand. You can also specify the amount. I'm just going to leave it as 1. If we open up our quest book yet, you can see we have a category, and we can also close this, by the way, and it will open up the same entry we just looked at. Isn't that cool? So test quests and submit one quest book. Right click, click for manual submit. If I don't have this quest book in my hand, and just open it, by the way, you can also open it by typing slash quests. However, it will open up the main menu instead of the last entry you looked at. And if I click it, nothing's going to work. I do have an enchanted book, however, it does not match the item's metadata I specified, because it does respect lore, name, enchantments, everything. So if I pick up this quest book again, you can see I can submit it, because and it will take the item. So I can claim the reward, and luckily I will get the quest book again. This is basically how it works. This quest is now completed. Because we haven't specified a cooldown, we can't complete it again. So we are just gonna create a new quest here. And this time it's gonna be It's gonna be a kill quest, two kill quests. First time kill, and this is also cool. You can change the entity by opening up this menu. I think it's pretty cool. So you can have Ender Dragons, Rivers, Snowman, Iron Golems, everything. However, we're going to specify a rabbit. So you have to kill 2 rabbits. And you have to kill 1 named rabbit. So kill named mob, rabbit, and what's gonna be the name? Bunny. So we have to kill 2 rabbits and 1 name. 1 rabbit has to be called Bunny. So we spawn in 2 rabbits. We are just gonna... I should have given myself a sword. So, where's the rabbit? Did he jump off? Dang it. Anyway, if you're gonna kill this rabbit, you can see this task has to be was completed to 50%. We have to kill another rabbit in order to complete it completely. And if we do so... this mission is completed. However, this is not, because it has to be named Bunny. So if we give ourselves a name tag really quickly and change its name to Rabbit, we can spawn in a new rabbit, name it Rabbit. Oh no, Bunny was the name, right? Bunny. So we have a bunny called Bunny, and if we kill it, Yeah, I killed it. You can see the quest is now completed because we killed a rabbit which name was Bunny. And we can claim a reward, but we haven't specified any rewards, so it won't get us anything. So yeah, that's it probably for the quest types. Now I'm going to show you the quest requirement. I am going to create a new quest, if I could type correctly. Alright, so I went ahead and created a requirement test category to show you the quest requirement. I'm going to open this with shift left click and then added the second quest. And this time I'm going to set the quest requirement to be derp, this quest right here. So if we open up our quest book, you can see that this quest is locked. You cannot open it, you cannot complete it, you can't do anything with it. Because we haven't done this quest for it. Because this quest requires this quest to be finished first, so you can create an entire storyline of quests. And this also works for categories, so I can, for example, require this category to be only unlocked if this quest was done. So that's basically it for the requirement. I'm just going to show you the party menu really quickly, and then I'm going to wrap up this showcase, because I think it was a bit long, although it's a very complicated, or not complicated, a very complex plugin, however very user-friendly in my opinion. So the party menu is quite easy. You can just open up the party menu and then create a new party. You have now a party, your members are currently only me, because I'm the party leader. And as a party leader, you can invite a player or delete your party. And I'm just going to not invite anyone because there's not anyone else on the server. However, I could type in the player name now. And I'm only already a member of a party, so I can't invite myself. However, you could invite someone and it's going to pop up with a tell war message saying, "Would you like to join this party? Accept, deny." And you click on the text on the chat, in the chat, and it's going to add you to the party. And what the party does, it basically shares your quest progress with all party members. So if you complete a quest, or partially complete a quest, the progress will be shared immediately to all your party members. So if we were two players and I kill one rabbit for the two rabbits quest, the one rabbit will be shown as killed on the second player's quest book as well. I think that's pretty neat. And that's all, pretty much all there is about it to this plugin. You can go ahead and download it on Bukkit Dev or Spigot. I will be providing a Bukkit Dev link in the description as well as a link to a CS Callup, because that's a requirement for this plugin in order to work, just as all my plugins require CS Callup. And if you want, you can also go ahead and download Vault in order to have a monetary reward. I might be adding future soft dependencies, like MCMMO maybe, to give MCMMO skill levels as a reward. Or maybe Citizens. Citizens is highly requested as a hookup, as a hook. And I don't know, you can vote for some things on the poll, on the plugin dev page. Feel free to do so, feel free to install this plugin, and I hope you enjoyed this showcase. So, that's it, and goodbye.